vascular diseases, diabetes mellitus, cancers, chronic respiratory diseases are among the top killers in the Philippines, causing more than half of all deaths annually. Hypertension and diseases of the heart are among 10 leading causes of illnesses each year. So one of those risk factors are
stress
and smoking.
One of the leading causes of death in the Philippines is cardiovascular disease. And one of the risk factors of it is smoking.
So guys, when you're smoking, the nicotine stimulates your body to release adrenaline. And when your body releases adrenaline, it will cause vasoconstriction to your blood vessels, which will eventually lead to hypertension. So think twice before you smoke.
Excessive accumulation of adipose tissue in the body due to consuming more food than is required for energy. You are deemed obese if you have a BMI over 30 kilograms per meter.
Obesity is generally caused by eating too much and moving too little. If you consume high amounts of energy, particularly fat and sugars, but you don't burn off the energy through exercise and physical activity, much of the surplus energy will be stored by the body as fat.
A sedentary lifestyle is a type of lifestyle involving no physical activity. The person living a sedentary lifestyle is often sitting or lying down while engaging in an activity like reading, socializing, watching television, and playing video games for much of the day. A sedentary lifestyle can potentially contribute to ill health and many preventable causes of death.
Sedentary lifestyle could very well be among the 10 leading causes of death and disability in the world. And it also increases all the causes of mortality, double the risk of cardiovascular disease, diabetes, and obesity, and increase the risk of colon cancer, high blood pressure, osteoporosis, lipid disorder, depression, and anxiety.
That's all. See you on our next vlog.
One of the main causes of death in the Philippines.
Oh, shit!